हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू फ्रेमवर्ड एजुकेशनल हब। माय सेल्फ ऐश्वर्या सक्सेना एंड टुडे इन द सीरीज ऑफ जुपिटर नोटबुक आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू कोड एंड दैट वुड बी ऑफ स्कैटर प्लॉट। सो आई एम टेकिंग अ न्यू सेल हियर एंड आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग स्कैटर प्लॉट एज द हेडिंग। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन हिस्टोग्राम, आई होप यू हैव वॉच्ड दैट वीडियो एंड दिस इज द सिक्स्थ वीडियो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर जुपिटर नोटबुक सीरीज। सो आई होप यू आर फॉलोइंग ऑल द tasks which we are dealing here. So now I am just coming towards the scatter plot website. So I am just going to show you some official websites. I will share the link in the description, so you will find it easier to understand the things. Because scatter plot, let me show you the scatter plot here. Basically, scatter plots come in this particular manner. You can see the images, and here I am just coming towards some. Okay, this I am coming here, and you can see scatter plot is used to get the value of data at a particular point. Basically, so when we are dealing with scatter plot, basically it is used for the data on some specific point, on a particular point. So that is the main purpose of using scatter plot. So scatter plots we can use, and this is also having a lot of content related to scatter plot. What is scatter plot, and like which kind of data which you can use when you are using scatter plot, and many more. So I will just share this link in the description, so you can just refer this also. So after that, I am just coming back towards my matplotlib, so we can just understand the code for scatter plot here. Okay, so here I am not importing the matplotlib again because I have already imported it in the notebook which we are using. So I am just taking the variables. I am taking a list here, and I'm taking some values here. And 10 values I have taken here for the x. Now I'm just taking 10 values for the y also. Some random values which will be plotted with respect to this. So I have taken 10 different values here. Okay, after this I am just taking plt.scatter. So for the scatter plot we have to take plt.scatter x comma y comma label. Now whenever we are taking this label, it is necessary to take a legend. So I will tell you what is the meaning of legend. I am taking here stars, that is a label, and then I am taking marker here. So marker is basically which will be representing. Like I'm taking this as star, so it will be the graph will be represented with the help of stars. S equals to 30, that is the size, and the color I'm taking color equals to green. So this I have taken the color. After that I'm taking plt.xlabel, that is the label which would be appearing on the x-axis, that is x-axis itself. I'm taking x-axis to be written. Then plt.ylabel and plt.ylabel I'm taking y-axis. Okay, after that I am taking plt.title for the title on the graph, and that I am taking scatterplot. The scatterplot I have taken. Then as I have told you, whenever we are using this label we have to use legend. So I am taking plt.legend. So plt.legend I am taking, and here I am just taking plt.show to show the graph. So these things we have taken here. Now let's run this program. Control enter I am pressing to run the code. Okay, so let's see. Matplotlib has no attribute scatter. Okay, fine. So just because of double t which I have missed here, so that's why it's not appearing. Now you can see that it is running here. This is star, this asterisk is representing that it is running, and now you can see we have got the scatter plot here. So now you can see this particular box which is having the marker and the label, this box is known as legend. So whenever we are taking the label and the label, basically we should take the legend, otherwise it will not appear. Now the position of this legend is not fixed, it could be anywhere according to the values which are appearing on the graph. Like if we will change some values on the graph, we will change the values, so accordingly it will just change the position of the legend. So it depends on the, basically it depends on the values which are appearing on the graph. Accordingly, it takes a position. I am just changing some values to show you that our graph is here now. You can see the differences which are coming because of the values which we have taken. Okay, though this way you can see, we can just plot the scatter plot, and this is the scatter plot basically. Okay. I hope you are understanding the concepts which we are taking here in the series, and I hope you are understanding. Now you can see the position of the legend has been changed because the value which I have taken must be like it is appearing here, so it could not take this position, neither it can take this position, so it is appearing here. So according to the values which have been plotted to the graph, it takes the value, the legend takes the position actually. So this is the way of working with the scatter plot. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and don't forget to share the series, and please subscribe the channel if you are new to this channel. Thanks for watching. See you in the next lecture.